Welcome to Final Cut Pro 10 in under 5 minutes. I'm Steve from RippleTraining.com. Last week, Apple released Final Cut Pro 10.2 with a host of useful mask options. This week, I want to show you how to create transitions using clips that include an alpha channel. I'll start by moving my playhead over the stack of clips. As you can see from the thumbnails, both clips are beach-related. Using a mask and a third clip of an animated starfish, we're going to create a wipe from the top clip to the bottom clip. Press X on your keyboard to mark a range for the clips. In the browser, I'll locate my starfish clip. To quickly determine if a clip contains an alpha channel, choose Alpha from the View menu. An alpha channel determines areas of transparency and opaqueness within a clip. The black pixels are treated as transparent, and the white areas are treated as opaque. Alpha channels are embedded when a movie is exported from Motion or After Effects, using a codec that supports alpha channels, either Apple's ProRes 4444 or the older animation codec. Set the channel view back to all. Press Q to connect the starfish clip above the stack of beach clips. Because we set a range on the clip, the connected clip matches the duration of the clips beneath it. Skimming over the starfish clip reveals the clip directly below it in the areas of transparency defined by the alpha channel. We want to use the starfish as a wipe to reveal the bottom clip as it passes from left to right through the frame. We'll do this using an animated mask. I'll move the playhead to roughly the midpoint of the animation, where you can see most of the starfish. I'll then select the beach clip directly below it and double-click the Draw Mask thumbnail to apply it. From the Shape Type pop-up menu, choose Linear. Linear masks are masks that do not have any splines that allow you to create a curve at the control point. They're great when you need a mask that's angular in nature. Before you begin creating the mask, you'll want to zoom out a bit so you can see the gray area around the image. I'll set the first control point by clicking in the area above the top arm of the starfish, then click in the center of the star, followed by a third control point in the area outside the lower arm. Continue clicking in the gray area outside the frame, then close up the mask by clicking the first control point. I now have a mask that's roughly shaped like an arrow. In the inspector, I'll add keyframes for all the draw mask properties, then close the inspector to give more screen real estate to the viewer. I'll then move the playhead to the frame where the starfish has made a complete exit. Drag the mask to the right until the point is touching the right edge of the frame. Step through the clip using your left arrow key until you clearly see a frame where the mask is off its mark. Correct the mask position by dragging it, then adjust the control points to account for the fact that the starfish is doing a slight rotation as it leaves the frame. Now step through the clip frame by frame and adjust the mask position and control points as necessary to keep the mask centered on the starfish. Continue stepping backward toward the beginning of the clip. One useful tip is you can manipulate control points as a group. Drag a rectangle over the three control points over the starfish. A white dot in the center of each control point lets you know they're grouped. Moving one now moves them all. Drag the center point until the mask is realigned with the starfish. Keep stepping backward, adjusting control points to keep the mask centered. To return to individual point manipulation, click in the gray area to deselect, then adjust any control point as needed. Continue adjusting the mask shape until the starfish is no longer visible on the left side of the frame. Use your arrow keys to step through the animation, checking for any area where the mask needs refinement. Let's play back to see how it looks. Press X to set a range, then press the / key to play back. Very cool! Now you can create transitions from any clip containing an alpha channel. If you're interested in learning more, check out our Final Cut Pro 10.2 in-depth tutorial, where I show you even more things you can do with masks, as well as cover all the new 3D title options. Click the link below to check it out.